Okay guys, so today we're going to be taking a look at comparing the old versus the new in combat knives. Now of course this video is going to be having to relate more to the utility side of combat knives as opposed to the combat side because, one, don't have any applicable test subjects, and two, to be quite honest, in the changing days of combat, simply, knives don't see that much action. Now, that's not saying that they aren't important, and that's not saying that you shouldn't carry one for self-defense, but by and large, the majority of a combat knife's role is going to be on the modern battlefield utility. And in front of you guys, I think I have two pretty good options, or two pretty good comparisons of a very old school classic combat utility knife and a new school combat utility knife. So without any further ado, let's just jump right into it. So this isn't going to be a video discussing why a new or old system is better. Obviously, the new combat knife is better in every way. This has better steel, it has better ergonomics and engineering, but this is more to discuss the changes and kind of evolution of old school knives or old school combat utility versus new school combat utility, and to explain the changes that they've went through. So in the beginning, actually many of your Camillus, Ontario, K-Bar, Camillus, Ontario, K-Bar styled knives looked just like this. They were very homogeneous without much real development. They were very basic knives used for general utility. And at the time these knives were manufactured, fighting with a knife was still on its way out, but an actual reality. And I think one of the largest shifts you'll see in a modern combat knife versus a old school combat knife is that shift from fighting to utility. If you look at this knife here, this is a CRK Pacific. It certainly does have some, you know, pretty pronounced features, guard, and I've actually taken the top guard off, so there used to be even more pronounced top guard up here. So there certainly is some fighting in this knife, but by and large, by its design, its blade shape, it's really its handle shape more than anything, this knife just isn't really designed for actual combat use. And what I mean by combat use is actual fighting hand-to-hand with knives. And that's not necessarily a problem, because as I mentioned in the beginning of this video, the reality is for combat utility knives, the times have changed largely. They just aren't seeing actual fighting. So the emphasis and pressure has been put more on the utility side. So immediately it becomes apparent whenever you pick up something like this CRK Pacific as opposed to the K-Bar, you'll see that there's positive ergonomics and grip. You can choke up on the blade to get better control over the edge for doing detail work. You can actually use this knife for true utility, survival, and bushcraft like I have in the past with this CRK Pacific. Whereas the K-Bar, while it's not a bad utility knife and it's not a unusable survival knife, it certainly lacks a lot of the ability that something like the CRK Pacific holds. So overall, this is kind of just a comparative study. Obviously, new combat knives are going to be much better in all ways. Like I said, steel, ergonomics, and everything, the just refinement process as a whole is going to be better. And of course, you usually pay for that in cost, because this particular knife, you know, is around $350 to $400. And, you know, even other knives by Spartan Blades that are similar to this, you know, run in the same range or price range. They're just going to be more expensive, but you do really get what you pay for. Something like this K-Bar is cheaper because it's simply less refined. The handle lacks any type of direction, and while it might be a superior fighting knife due to the blade length and the fact that it has very pronounced forward or top and bottom guards, overall the knife is going to, for the most part, serve you less. So anyways guys, that's basically all I have to say about new versus old school combat utility knives. I just thought it'd be a fun kind of comparison because I have the two blades out here to explain some of the differences and kind of showcase the differences between a new and an old combat knife. As always, guys, God bless, and I'm out.